In this video, I'm going to show you how you can take a handful of AutoCAD shortcuts and then create a 2D elevation from them in just a fraction of time that it would normally take you. This whole drawing approach eliminates having to explore through countless menus, pulldowns, and ribbons, essentially saving you an incredible amount of time. I'm Eric, and I'm from simplecad.com, and I teach CAD users how to learn the essential AutoCAD skills they need in order to create better quality drawings that much faster with a lot less effort. So let's get started. Let's do some lines, rectangles, and circles. So to get started, first we're just going to work in what's called a clean screen. Press Control 0. So we're going to start by drawing a line just by typing L for line and then pressing Enter. Keep in mind you need to press Enter after each command, or AutoCAD won't detect that you want to start that command. Enter also repeats the last command. So let's go ahead and put the first point in. Then we'll type 28 feet. We're pointing the cursor in the direction we want to go as well. And then we press Enter as well for that. And now it wants to draw another line at this point. So we press Escape. The Escape key gets you out of a command that you might be in. Now, if you're not seeing the tab boxes near the cursor, you need to turn on what's called DYNMODE and just make sure that's set to 3. If we want to repeat that last command, like I was saying, just press Enter, and then we're going to go ahead and snap to the midpoint of this line. Now, I'm going to get into what these snaps are a little bit later, but for this point in time, we're just going to left click, and we're going to go up and type 20. So now we've got two lines drawn. Let's go ahead and draw a rectangle with the REC command. Again, we're going to snap to the endpoint of this line just by left-clicking where we see the little square. And then, again, we need to type in these distances. So for the top distance, 20 feet. And then we're going to tab to the right side and then type in 9 feet. So let's go ahead and draw another rectangle in here. And remember, we can just press the Enter key to repeat the last command. And then we're just going to put one up here. We'll left click on the endpoint. Then again, we're going to fill in these fields. We're going to go with 10 feet. And then tab, and then 5.5. Now 5.5, we don't have to put inches behind it. We can just type 5.5. Now if you were working in millimeters, it would be 5.5 millimeters. These are what are called units in AutoCAD. So let's repeat that last command one more time and do another rectangle down here. Left click, same thing. Tab into these fields. The first one will be 3 feet. Tab, and then we're going to type in 7 feet for the height. So lastly, let's draw a circle using the C command. And the center of the circle, let's go ahead and just put it right here in the center of the door for now. And for the radius, we can just type in 1.6 here. So notice in our example, we've got the door, window, roof, and wall that we're working on. So AutoCAD by default just wants to select entities. So if I select this entity, this, this, and this, these pieces become what are called a selection set. If I click on one of these grips and press my space bar on my keyboard, I immediately go into the move mode. So let's go ahead and type in 4 feet for this. The second part, I'm going to explain a little bit about what grips are and also a little bit about the polar and ortho snap settings. Let me go ahead and zoom down here. As you noticed, so far I've been working in ortho mode. There's also another mode called polar tracking, and we can toggle this on here. And we can right click and look at the angles that we have selected. And right now we have 30 degrees. We can add different angles to this as well later, just by going into the settings. What polar tracking allows me to do is snap to different angles. So I could pick this rectangle, pick it by its vertex here, and then press the space bar, and I press it 2 times to get into my rotation command. So as you remember, the first time is the move command, then the second time is going to be your rotation command. So a super quick way to rotate an object. So I'm going to zoom down with the scroll wheel. I'm going to pick the vertex here. And then I'm going to make sure I'm on that snap angle again of 30 degrees. And then I'm going to type in 2 feet. Now press escape. I wanted to quickly pause for a second and mention that I have a free 3-page PDF that has all the keyboard shortcuts mentioned in this video, plus a whole lot more, using the link below this video. Now I can do the same thing with the circle and the rectangle. I can move these over to the center of the elevation. As you select things, you can select them by an area as well. So here I'm selecting everything within the boundary of this box, which picks up the circle and the rectangle. But if you select it in the opposite way, lower right to upper left, all the things that cross this window will get selected. So let's go ahead and pick it by the grip here. Press the space bar and then move it here. You can see it's found the intersection of that line and the rectangle. So we're going to left click. And then we're going to take this circle here, select it, and move it just the same way. Select it again. Here we want to move it between this point and this point. And the easiest way of doing that is to use what's called a transparent command that we can type in as we're moving it. Type in MTP. That moves it to the center of 2 points. So we press enter and we specify the first point and then we specify the second point and it puts it right straight in the middle of those 2 points. If I need to move up a little bit higher in my drawing, I can type in the P key and then simply pan down so I have some room to work. You can also use the middle scroll wheel of your mouse, hold that down. That's a much quicker way as well. Again, I can zoom down as needed with my scroll wheel. One thing I wanted to mention is these are actually all grouped together to what's called a polyline. And a polyline is basically what holds all the grips. It's so much easier to work with polylines versus straight lines, just because things are all grouped together. The next thing I want to talk about is object snaps. Now I mentioned this earlier in the video as we were snapping to things, but your settings for that, if you go down here, highlight over this icon here, right click, have a look at what's toggled on. We have endpoint, midpoint, intersection, and perpendicular. So these are the snaps that are currently active in this drawing. So I just wanted to show you that because we're going to be using this intersection snap again. And for the final part of this video, I'm going to show you how to mirror, explode, erase, and trim. So let's zoom down with our scroll wheel and then look at this roof here. So we're going to select this vertex, come up, and then find the intersection here. We can do the same here, just slowly drag it up and then snap to the intersection to the center line of our elevation. So let's add the roof to the other side of our drawing. So when AutoCAD creates these rectangles, they're actually polylines. So let's mirror it to the other side by typing MI for mirror. And we'll select 2 points of our mirror line. By default, it does not delete the original entity, so we just press enter. And then we have the other side of our roof. So again, this whole thing is a rectangle. And if we wanted to delete this line on top, we're going to have to explode this rectangle into lines. So in order to do so, we can press the X key to explode. And now when we select it, now they're all individual lines. So let's select this line and this line, and then we'll type E for erase. And next, let's just start adding some trim around the door and window here. So the easiest way of doing that is just to use the offset command or the O command. And we give it a distance. We're going to give it 5.5 inches. And here we can just select the rectangle and then specify the offset side. Same thing here. And now if I wanted to trim this to the floor line here, I could do that just by selecting this line, typing TR, and then selecting this rectangle to trim. Again, because this is still a rectangle, it trims all together. Or if these were individual lines, we would have to select them individually. I'm gonna go ahead and move this line down just by pressing the space bar and typing 6 inches. And now I just need to draw a small line here to here, and then move it in 1.5 inches. Now I could just mirror this line just by typing MI and then mirroring it to the other side. And throughout the process of this video, hopefully I've showed you that you can use the command lines using grips, Osnaps, and then the status bar area down here to quickly get your drawing done without slowing yourself down with menus and ribbons that you're normally going to find in a standard AutoCAD installation. Again, make sure you take advantage of my free 3-page PDF that has all the keyboard shortcuts mentioned in this video, plus a whole lot more using the link below this video. Thanks and have a great day. Bye.